Hello friends, I am P.R. Kulkarni and today we will be discussing about the flow diagram. The outcome of the today's session will be, you will be able to draw a flow diagram for the given problem. The flow diagram, as you know, is a drawing or a diagram drawn to a scale to show the relative position of a machine, equipment, jigs and fixtures, gangways, aisles, and shows that the path followed by the material or the machine, or in some cases it can be a person also. The flow diagram is a pictorial view of the entire process followed by material, man, machine, equipment and so on. And the purpose of the flow diagram is we understand how the total process moves, and then will be able to find out whether value added and non-valued activities are happening in that particular process. The ultimate aim will be to remove the non-value added items, non-value added movement, non-value added inspection processes and such areas, where the purpose will be to simplify the process, to remove the non-value added items and make the total application in a better method. Various applications are, it is to document a process for better understanding, quality control and training of the employees. We can train the people once you understand the process and show the same process in a pictorial form. To standardize a process for optimal efficiency and repeatability. The present status is known to us, and then we can find out the present efficiency, remove the unnecessary movements, and then we will be able to go for optimal efficiency of the particular process. To study a process for efficiency and improvement. It helps to show unnecessary steps, bottlenecks and other inefficiencies. To model a better process or create a brand new process. If it is observed that the present process is quite clumsy, it has lot many of repeatable elements, and then it is better to have an entirely new process than modifying the existing process. To communicate and collaborate with diagrams that speak to various roles in the organization or outside of it. It is observed that pictorial view is always better as compared to the text form as such. Now we'd like to draw a flow diagram. Let us understand what is the procedure for drawing a flow diagram. First, we have to have the layout of the workpiece, which is drawn to the scale. Then afterwards, we have to show the relative positions of the various machines, workbenches, equipments and other accessories in the entire machine shop. We have to show the path followed by the material under study and is traced by drawing various lines, a thick line generally drawn, and the arrow movement will show the direction of the process. Each movement is serially numbered and indicated by arrow for direction. Different colors are used to denote different types of movements. Now this is an example of a flow diagram for manufacturing of a bicycle pedal process. It starts with the raw material. We take the raw material from the store, so it is a starting point of it. After taking the raw material, it is taken to the cutting shed. The raw material is cut into the required size. After cutting, it goes to the forging shop. Forging of the particular component is done. After forging, then it comes to the machine shop, where there are two operations shown in the machine shop. The first is turning section and other is the milling section. The first operation is turning, and then turning to milling it goes to. After milling, the entire the job goes to the heat treatment process, where heat treatment process is carried out. After heat treatment process, it is inspected, and if it is okay, it is sent to the assembly section, and after assembly, final inspection is done. Once final inspection is showing okay mark as such, then we will be handling this particular job to the part storage or final store, generally called as FG store in the typical organizational language as such. And then here afterwards, it can be further dispatched to the required destination through the dispatch section as such. So this is the flow diagram, where if you observe this, you will find a typical flow, straight line flow is there, and some heat treatment process, we have some backtracking and done. After studying this process, we should be able to analyze this process, and then analysis should be done on the following lines. The analysis is, now you have to think for a moment, what is the conclusion of this flow diagram, and what do you comment about the process, its flow, its backtracking, and whether the bottleneck of the particular operation is happening or not. Once you have understood it, now we have to study the path of the material, observe for backtracking. If any backtracking is observed, you have to repeat the material handling, you have to, if the backtracking is observed or in the repeat material handling is taking place, you have to note down that in particular, which particular two workstations are there where the backtracking is happening. We have to analyze why that backtracking is happening, whether layout can be changed or that was a temporary moment or particular for a batch, and what is the reason for the backtracking, whether any waiting of the particular job is done, whether it is the process change for that particular day, or whether it is some adjustment, or it is sheerly because of we have fixed a layout at a particular location on a particular product line, and then afterwards we have modified the product flow, we have modified the products and processes, but the layout has remained same. Generally it happens, it is a common experience for most of the organizations, that once a layout is formed, the products and the product material flow goes on changing, the layout remains same as old as it is. As a result of that, as the new lines are added, the backtracking for the material goes on improving, goes on increasing, and then it needs to have a look at whether the particular layout is giving the correct material handling or not, whether we are following the principles of material handling, and then once we are following the principles of material handling, we have to try and see that the maximum of the flow, maximize the flow by avoiding backtracking of the material handling. Once this is there, then the next comes, after analysis we have to go for the improvement phase, where it is generally called as the improvement in the method study. In method study we are trying to find out what is the present method and what is the proposed method. Once analysis of the present method is done, then we have to go for suggest suitable alternatives so that backtracking is eliminated or minimized. The best way is to eliminate the backtracking. It should have a straight line, single, simplified flow. It is called a generally maximization of flow in terms of lean manufacturing. If it is not possible, then we have to see that at least the backtracking is minimized, waiting is minimized, bottlenecking is minimized. For this matter, we have to have the layout experts, we can have brainstorming sessions, we can have the line diagrams, we can have simulation models, and then we can finalize the layout on the paper first, have a simulation, run it, and then see that whether backtracking can be avoided. Again, for this layout proposed, we have to use the basic principles of layout, which definitely act as a guidelines for maximizing the material flow and minimizing the bottlenecking or eliminating the backtracks. Once it is done, we have to go for a proposed flow diagram, where we have to comparing the existing flow with the proposed flow. Proposed flow diagram definitely will show what are the improvements possible, what is the total distance we are trying to minimize. The distance may be of material, may be of a equipment, or may be of a person. Once the proposed flow diagram is ready, we are going to compare the existing flow diagram with the proposed ones. The proposed should show improvements in terms of some of the areas, like as I said, minimization of the material handling movement. It should show the distance which is reduced after the changes in the method. It should also, if possible, try to see that whether workers or operators' stress is minimized or not. If it is not possible, then we have to think of some additional ergonomical designs in the same layout. Ergonomics definitely will help for the improvements. Once this is done, we have to find out what are the possible changes those are needed in the processes or in the layout. We have to work out the cost economics of it, and then we have to estimate the benefits. If there are some investments, we have to calculate the what is the ROI of the investment, considering the batch size of the equipment, what is the minimum return, minimum time it will take on the ROI. Generally 3 to 5 years of return of investment is generally taken. 3 years is supposed to be the best ROI for the given processes. Once these estimates are done, then we have to run it on a simulation, on a 2D, 3D modeling. We have the trial phase, we are conducting the trials. As the trials are taking place, probably there will be some issues related to the implementation. There will be some resistance from the worker side, because there is obviously a natural phenomena that people try to resist the change. Change may be much better than the earlier one. Initial phases, we have to overcome this particular resistance to change. Once that is there, once workers are taken into confidence, we should be able to convince to the operators, we should be convinced to the workers that this new method will definitely going to help them to reduce their movements, to reduce their stress, their physical handling, and it will also be helpful for improving the quality of the material, since the backtracking is avoided. That also will result into better quality, minimum damages to the workpieces, and so on. Once this is done, then implementation of the particular process, implementation with the necessary changes, we have to do it. Once we do this, then we have to compare the existing flow diagram with the improved flow diagram, and then try to compare where and what we have saved, how much it has helped to reduce it. In turn, that should also be able to make the possibilities of productivity improvement. Sometimes it happens that the material movement is reduced, worker movement is reduced, time is saved, but it is not reflecting into the final figure of the implementation in terms of productivity improvement. Once the improvement in the productivity is possible, we have to set the new norms, and then probably improvement will be a routine practice. So in short, in summary, what we are trying to understand is that we have to draw a flow diagram for the existing process, we have to draw for the improved process, compare the processes, try to minimize the material handling, and then improved material handling should result into the improved production, improved productivity, which is the value gain for the company. Thank you.